In this video, we're going to discuss how one can go from a security architect role or a cloud security architect role to a chief information security officer role. We're going to discuss why the architect is such a great pathway to, say, the CISO role. We're going to discuss how these careers are similar. We'll discuss how these careers are different. And then I'll talk about the skills that a good security architect would need to learn to transition from a security architect role to a chief information security officer or a CISO role. So if we look at the role of the chief information security officer, as well as the security architect, you're going to see there's a lot of similarities between the roles. Now, the focus of the roles are almost the same, but what we do in these roles, that's a bit different. So let's look at the focus of the roles and what we're doing in these roles. From a chief information security officer perspective, we have an executive level position that's going to be responsible for the strategic direction and overall management of the information security inside of an organization. So you can think of the chief information security officer as the person that focuses on aligning the security initiatives with the business objectives, managing the organization's risk, ensuring compliance, and leading the organization's security governance. Now, if I look at the security architect, here's what we're really dealing with. We're dealing with a hybrid executive and technology professional. Now, the security architect's going to be, generally speaking, be responsible for designing the security strategy or the architecture. And that's based upon aligning the security initiatives with the organization's business objectives, managing risk, ensuring compliance, and leading the organization's security governance. So the CISO is the person that's responsible, the head of it, and the security architect is helping that CISO by creating that overall strategy. Now, if we look at the CISO role, it's very strategic. It's predominantly strategic. Overall vision, overall security policies, overall strategic governance around the organization's security programs, a leadership level responsibility. But now if I take it back to the security architect, it's a little more technical. We're designing the security measures. We're designing the secure network infrastructures, the security for the systems, the security for the applications. So when we go back to the CISO role, more responsible for the vision and the policies, and with the architect role, we may help that organization write their policies. We may help that organization respond and create incident response procedures. We will be predominantly responsible for designing it, and we design it, typically speaking, for the CISO. So if we think about governance and policy for the organization, the person that owns the security policy, typically speaking, is the chief information security officer, as well as other C-suite roles. So the CISO is developing and enforcing the organization-wide security policy, guidelines, standards, what have you. And from a risk management perspective, they're identifying, assessing, and managing security risks. Now, they're developing the, or at least overseeing the incident response and crisis management. So what are we dealing with the architect level? Well, we're actually designing these same plans. We might be designing some risk management strategies. We might be designing some compliance plans in our architecture to make sure it complies with, say, GDPR or HIPAA. We might be creating incident response procedures. Who speaks to the press, for example? Who does what? Who's the incident response team? So we're doing almost the same thing, but the CISO is responsible, and the architect is, again, doing and designing some of those things for the actual CISO. Now, if we look at the scope of influence, here's where it depends on how skilled the architect is to determine how similar they are or not. The CISOs, or Chief Information Security Officer, has a big, broad scope of influence because they're an executive. They work across all departments, across all stakeholders. They speak to the board. They're constantly communicating with the organization's executives. They're setting security priorities for the organization. Now we go back to the security architect. They're still working with vendors. They're typically working with internal stakeholders, the CIO, the CISO, as well as many IT engineering teams. So again, you're dealing with similar people, but the CISO's influence is bigger and more executive-like. And the security architect is half executive, half technology, because the architect role is half executive, half technology professional. Now, from a decision-making perspective, the chief information officer is considered a decision maker. They're going to make decisions that affect that entire organization, including security budgeting for programs, risk tolerance, overall security strategy. Now, what's the security architect doing? They are providing the information to advise this chief information security officer to help that chief information officer make better decisions. So they're very similar but different. Now, on a risk management perspective, you know, here's where it gets kind of interesting. So the chief information officer focuses on enterprise level risk management, and they balance security priorities with business needs. Well, that's the same thing the security architect does. They focus on enterprise risk management, balance security priorities with business needs, manage broader organizational risks. So they're very similar. Now, there's a lot of collaboration in both of these roles. The chief information officer collaborates with the senior executives, the IT leaders, the legal department, compliance officers, and other business stakeholders. Who does the security architect work? Well, they work with engineers, they work with IT teams, they work with key stakeholders, they work with key vendors, and typically CIO, chief information officer, CTO, chief technology officer, and CISO leaders. So again, they're very similar, not too different from each other. Now, from a training and awareness perspective, the chief information security officer is going to be responsible for the organization's entire training programs. Now, the security architect is probably designing the security training programs for the entire organization. So, fairly similar, but the security architect will also create a lot of technical trainings, anti-phishing kind of training, anti-social engineering kind of training, potentially. Now, when it comes to communication with external stakeholders, that's predominantly a chief information security officer role. External stakeholders, customers, vendors, regulators, and partners to ensure safety and compliance standards are met. Now, the security architect has limited interaction with external stakeholders. We tend to, as architects, focus much more internal issues and internal stakeholders. Now, when we look at the reporting structure, your chief information security officer can either report to the CEO, and that would be in organizations where they value security very heavily, or they can often report to the chief information officer. That's often more common. Again, that would mean the IT department would own security, which is okay, possible too, or potentially even to others on the board of directors. So high level reporting for the chief information security officer. The security architect typically reports to, say, the chief information security officer or some other senior IT leadership. Now, as you can see, so much of the roles are very similar. It's that the chief information security officer is focused on more businessy things, more executive-y things, if you will. So what does it take to move from architect, security architect, or cloud security architect to chief information security officer? It involves taking all those lessons learned from your role as an architect, which was advising this person, and then getting those executive skills you need for the role. So what does that mean? Typically speaking, it means more business acumen, more knowledge of business and how business works. It typically involves having more executive presence so you can basically be seen as a leader amongst a greater number of stakeholders. It typically takes enhancing your leadership skills so you can lead and influence a larger audience of individuals. And it typically takes enhancing of your communication skills and your presentation skills, because now you're going to be presenting to boards or potentially venture capitalists or other C-suite executives. So they're most of the skills you already have. It's just enhancing these executive skills. And you do that, typically speaking, you have the skills for a chief information security officer role. So in this video, we talked about how the chief information security officer role in many ways is a good path to the C-suite, because you're doing things that are so similar and you're advising the C-suite in the role of a cloud architect or cloud security architect. Now, if you'd like to become a security architect or a cloud security architect, please join me on a completely free webinar where we will go over the role, talk about what we do, and I'll answer any questions you have personally about the career or anything in general. The link for that free webinar is in the description of this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your architecture career, whether it's a cloud architecture career, enterprise architecture career, AI architecture career, or security architecture career. I look forward to seeing you in a webinar or another video very soon. Take care.